first of all, is remove religion, forget religion. This is all about bloodline.
Ah, this is what I'm saying. I'm not dissing a man's religion. I'm taking a man back to his original heritage. That's all I'm saying.
So first, you know what? I haven't done enough research in terms of how we used to live in the law. But the research that I have done has showed me who I am. So when someone would ask, okay, then, how are we supposed to be living then? I'm not 100% sure yet because I want to do the research properly. And if I'm going to be honest, you know, when I start doing that research, I'm going to learn how to speak biblical Hebrew so I can go and read the text myself. So I'm not following anyone.
Let me jump in a sec. Sorry, fam. Do you want to know what? I'm not saying this is easy, but do you know how we can find out how we're meant to be living? Yeah? Just look at everybody else, fam. Look at the so-called Jews, and then look at Islam, and tell me how they're flourishing when Islam comes from the first five books of the Bible, and the Jews are impersonating the Israelites. So obviously they must be doing something that we're supposed to be doing, but we're not doing it. They are. They're living out like there's something called a kosher diet. So if you've got a kosher diet, that means you don't eat certain food, but you're not the Israelites. So if you've got a kosher diet and you're Israeli, that means you've got my Bomba Clark diet, G. That's my diet. Yeah? If Islam is based on... Right, Islam is based off Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy.
Yeah?
But Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, fucking to Deuteronomy, is nothing about Ishmael.
No. Stop. Wait there.
He's already brainwashed thinking, you know why man say that, fam? Because they believe that the Bible is a white man's book, and on the very first fucking page it says this is a translation. How do you translate your own language?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm translating something, it was never mine in the first place.
Yeah.
What them man don't understand is every person in the Bible that the Bible is referring to as the nation of Israel is black. Every person in the Bible that wrote something down was a black man. But they've been taught it's a white man's book. That's how they've got no power. They think it's just a white man wrote this book. So we don't need to listen to that.
Wait. You know what I would say to that?
Go on.
If that's the case, then why would they give us the book during slavery?
Because you know what it is, fam? You know when you translate something, yeah? You translate it, but then you can change the meaning of the word. Remember, we've got an English language, innit? So we've got words that mean three different things. So now, when you talk of the English language and I say, all right, slaves, obey your earthly master.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's like, yo, the Bible's not about slaves. But guess what? What if that's telling me, as a black man, to obey Zimbo, who's my master, because I work for him?
Mm-hmm.
Is there a problem? And I might be your servant. But guess what? No one ever reads after that. The very next scripture, a master do likewise unto your servants.
Yeah, you told me this before.
Because you know what it's all about? How we deal with each other as a nation.
Yeah.
So, there was never no white man who had black man as slaves in the Bible. So the Bible's not talking to slaves to obey that master. He's saying, yo, when you're working for your black brethren, who might be a king, because I might have a man who, yo, if there's a black king on this planet now, I'd rather work for him. If he's moving righteous under God, there's no reason not to obey him, because he's going to deal with you just as good as you deal with him.
All right, wait there. Someone says, we have bodies of artifacts of African kings and queens in museums worldwide, but no one from the white people would operate. Let me answer that.
Yeah, you answer that one there, Carl. I'll put him to bed.
Nah, but I'm just the logic of it, yeah. The logic. We're going to have a good chat later.
Yeah, you don't know, bro. I'm coming over in a bit. I'm flying over.
The logic of it, yeah. They remove these knowledge of who those people are from history. So of course, you're not gonna have artifacts or bones or anything of those people, because that would then prove who those people are. So it wouldn't make sense to have any of those anywhere that the public would have access to. You would put that shit in the bottom of the bag where nobody could see it, and
do you know what I say to that, bro? Anyone ask me that, I just say, yo, 12 miles of hidden artifacts under fucking the Vatican. What's under there?
Yeah, but, yo, I don't know. Not even
I don't
that.
Know, so don't come and...
No, but remember, you know, remember, the Crusades was about getting rid of a whole heap of information. The Knight Templar went around the world for the church and destroyed as much information as they could, and that information was definitely
right then. This
the original seed of Israel is.
Thank you. This, you know what it is, brother.
For now, I don't want to speak about the Abrahamic faith. I just want to speak about who I am, who my people are, based on historical facts.
Yes, historical facts.
Once we've identified that, then we can get into them. Because once we've identified that, then we can deal with everything else. First of all,
bro, man can dash with the Bible if they want. Man can, but listen, I will let man fling the Bible to one side, and I will bring factual, historical.
I do. You know me. I'm not,
you taught me that, fam. Cause I remember, I'm the man who like the Bible.
It's not the Bible like that, but I know who my people is.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Do you know what it is, fam? You know the worst thing? What enough people in England don't understand, and I want everyone in this live to understand this now, yeah? King James was a black man.
All right.
Yeah?
All right.
King motherfucking James was a black man.
Right.
King motherfucking James was a black man. Yeah?
All right.
King motherfucking James was a black man. Guy Fawkes came trying to blow up King James, yo. When you're doing Guy Fawkes night, Guy Fawkes was trying to blow up King James, the black man that sanctioned the Bible. So why do we celebrate Guy Fawkes night, not the attempted assassination of King James?
All right. Alright.
Because the man them who tried to kill him are still in power now. Yeah?
Oi,
they're not ready for this issue, fam. This issue is going to blow man out of their face.
Bye.